Hello, I want to make a short webcast demonstrating how I hacked a bit on Antidote and Syringe to add a feature which would allow to connect to labs using a GUI desktop through VNC. So this is also a demo of how you can test locally the Antidote web and Syringe without having a full Kubernetes cluster started. So this is a recent addition that Matt made where you can find the documentation on hacking on the Antidote platform, where you'll find instructions on how you can try and use the make hack make file target in the Antidote web repository, which will use Docker Compose to start a fake syringe and the needed web interface to be able to connect locally and test. So this is what I'm going to do. So I have checked out and I can do this make hack, which will rebuild the web part of Antidote that run the web interface. So basically under the hood there is the Apache Guacamole application which is rebuilt. This is what you see here with Maven, and at the end it will run a few containers that you can see here started, and here we have the logs of all those containers. So basically there are three main containers for Antidote web, Syringe and GUI-CD, and another set of containers for a fake lab. So what I did is I modified Syringe. So it's in my fork of the project in a branch called VNC-mock, where I basically added a fake API for Syringe. So this is not the real Syringe that starts labs on a Kubernetes cluster. It's just an API that pretends to be Syringe and that gives Antidote web what it needs. So here I extended it to add a desktop kind of connection that will connect through VNC on port 5900 on a particular lab that will run a Docker container that I prepared. So this Docker container is in my fork of NRE Labs curriculum in a branch called VNC, and it's the utility VNC subdir where basically I'm starting from an Ubuntu machine and I'm adding Tiger VNC and a few FVWM Xterm which will expose port 5900 to be able to connect to the desktop through VNC. So what happens when make hack has started everything? So somewhere we can see that there is a desktop container that started in the background that will start VNC server and Xterm and so on. So there is a lab already started here. There's also GUI-CD that is able to connect to it, and the rest of the Guacamole and the web interface that is started through a Tomcat web app here. So let's try and connect. So if I go to the localhost IPv4 address on port 8080, I can connect to the web interface. So this is reflected in the fact that the logs will probably exhibit something. I can try and connect to the contents, and here there's a fake lesson that appears, antidote test lesson. You can see that a syringe mock was activated by connection to the exp lesson endpoint of the REST API of the syringed-mock. So syringed-mock, if you remember, it's here, sorry, it's here, and if we can look at the contents of, sorry, of this file, if I'm able to display the full set of, sorry, that's just my diff. If I'm going back to this branch and its content, so it's in CMD, syringed-mock, main, I think, or mocks. Sorry. So mocks contains the fake API, which says, oh, we, here on exp, we know about three endpoints for a lesson, which is called antidote test lesson, and so on and so forth. And this lesson will start in principle a lab which contains a VNC desktop. So here, oh, sorry, here we can connect to this lesson and actually it will start or pretend to start. Actually, nothing happens because the containers were already started, so there is no start of a lab on Kubernetes. So guess what? We have the three endpoints that we can see here, Linux accessible through SSH, web server on HTTP, and a desktop on VNC. So here we have Linux on port 22, so that's here a container, but it's not started on Kubernetes, it's started locally through Docker Compose. Oops, sorry. So here it's one of the containers that got started here. That's the one here, Linux one. And the rest is the web server. So here we have an empty web page. So that's the second one, web server one here. And that was the one that got started here. Maybe we have some logs when it is, no, we don't see the Apache logs. And in the end, when we connect through this VNC here, we have a graphical desktop where we can do stuff. And so this is my image that is documented here, if you remember. And that is started here, saying, oh, I want VNC connection on 5900. And here, GUI-D actually created a proxy for VNC, and which allowed us to connect through the guacamole graphical display. So it's a VNC client that guacamole provides for us. So guacamole, which is already in Antidote, brings us this SSH proxy as a web canvas, or a VNC client as a web canvas. So I didn't use Kubernetes, I didn't use self-medicate, but I'm still able to start through Docker Compose a set of containers that can run particular lessons that I created locally, like this particular image that embeds VNC. And we see that displayed locally, so it's pretty good performance-wise. I guess that's it, and that's a demo of the capacity to add a new kind of endpoints running VNC. So there was just a tiny patch I committed to Antidote Web to just make sure that one can connect through VNC in addition to SSH, and passing it to Guacamole. So Guacamole was already available, and there was pretty much nothing to modify in Antidote Web. So I guess that's it, and thanks for watching.